us a section of worship. We give God the glory. Turn to your neighbor. Look straight into the person's eyes and tell that person, I love you through the love of Jesus. Or give that person some bold smile from the depths of your heart. A real one, nothing cosmetic. If the person did not smile, relocate. Get another seat and be happy where you're sitting there. Hallelujah. Because tell the person, fasten your seatbelts. You're about to take off. Amen. And because the subject under discussion is a subject that touches the very foundations of our life. It's a subject that has the roots in our life, character, and behavior. Amen. And I know that this is not convenient. I know it's not convenient to talk about this. We rather be in a church where we get excited. The Lord is going to bless you. The Lord is going to prosper you. Hallelujah. I know I don't know how to do that. But in all of that, you know, there is a requirement from God. Amen. A requirement from God. We are called to be as citizens of the kingdom of God. We are called to be different from our people that are living in the society. Amen. And that difference is not by material possession, because some of the folks living among us are materially blessed more than we are. So if that was the call, then it's not going to be effective. If that was the measurement of spirituality, if the measurement of spirituality is by the amount of things that you possess materially, then some folks are, you know, spiritually better than us, if there's anything like that. But we are called to be different. We are called to be world changers. We are called to, you know, to become citizens, to reflect the true citizens of the kingdom of God. And the only problem for that to happen after we have been born again is that we have found ourselves to be selfish. Tell somebody, selfish. Ask a person close to you, are you selfish? And the problem of selfishness is the very foundation of the depravity of human life. All the chaos and all the problems around us, where we seem to be having committees and meetings among governmental leadership, is all about selfishness. That is the very foundation of the problem of life. Man is selfish. Man is selfish. And I think that, you know, our God, who in his omniscience understood this, and he said it is not good for man to be alone. There's some folk at the church. It's not good for man to be alone. Because when you are alone, how many of you ever get into a relationship and you find out that, you know, you don't like it anymore? Nobody's going to talk to you. Because the reason why you don't like it anymore is not because you don't need the emotional part of it, you're just selfish. Okay, now I'm going to keep it quiet. I love you now, I don't love you tomorrow, it's because you're selfish. The person, you have changed. Now, because they want to touch your finances, and you all want love without the finances. They want to touch your money. Don't use my days. I know they're not going to like me today, but it's all right. I'll be free from this. I'll be free. I want these people to come. I'm going to be preaching a nice sermon. You will be happy with me, but for now, stick along. You just in it. The problem is selfish. Next. The book of Philippians chapter 2 verse 3 to 4 is where I'm taking. I'm going to try to, I may not exhaust it today because you see, this is not a one time sermon. I'm trying to close up, to wrap it up, to end it up, but it's ain't working out for me because the more I try to, you know, I shorten this subject so that I can get to something that might make you like church, you know, I like our church, I like to belong here, and the more I try to shorten it, the more it becomes deeper. The book of Philippians chapter 2 verse 3 to 4 try to give us some insight to the things that needs to be done. So we read under these, try to make a prescription, a prescription, a cure for selfishness. Well, that's right. Say, let nothing, somebody say, let nothing be done through strife or vain glory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem other better than themselves. So I am supposed to look up to you and make you look better. I'm supposed to esteem you, project you, treat you better than myself. But that's not going to happen because I'm selfish. Another translation says, do nothing from selfishness or empty conceit, but with humility of mind, let each one of you regard one another as more important than himself. Do not merely look out for your own personal interests. Go to the next verse. Tell somebody, do not look for your personal interests. Look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of his own. Let it not just be for yourself, but also the interests of others. Imagine what a blessed world would be if every human being alive adopted this one simple principle. Imagine what the churches would be. Conflict would disappear. Strife will be banished. Enmity and jealousy will cease to exist. Think how our workplace environment will be all changed. Backstabbing, gossiping will all be things of the past because all of those backstabbing and gossiping are of selfish, roots. Office politics will be thrown back to a begun era. The need for litigation and lawsuits will be finished. There will not be need for lawyers and courts. If everybody is, looking at it for the interest of the other person, if we people begin to live a selfless life, some of the challenges, some of the things we call demons, some of the things we call devils that we work to buy, our prayer life will change. We will not have too many enemies. Many of us have enemies, and those enemies are of selfish interest creations. Anybody that is not agree with you is an enemy. I'm a villain. If he said no, that one is my enemy. Every time I come there, he's always opposing me. Because you're not supposed to have a mini opinion. Everybody's supposed to just accept what you say. And we know that, we're not going to get to that, but this is indeed a call for the church. When Paul the Apostle write the word so long, he struck directly at the root of the sinful nature of all men, selfishness. Selfishness is the foundation for sin. If you're living in sin, it becomes your selfish. If you're living in sin, it's not because the blood of Jesus Christ is not effective. It's not because Jesus has to come down again and personally come to you and say, you, I call you by name, this is Alexa, that's your name. come out, you know, I tell you, it's because you are selfish. You know what I mean? It's because you're selfish.
Amen.
Consider for a moment the person who is eating up in jealousy. What is the problem of jealousy? Selfishness. What is dominating their thought process? They look at other people with this, and you hear people say, I don't like all these things as they consume fuel. It's because don't like all these speakers, if I want to buy a car, just like the small one, selfishness. Jealousy. Look at them here. When I hear people talk like all these speakers that people are driving, it's making fuel to cost. It's out of selfishness. Jealousy. That's why, if they were the one driving, it would be fine. But because other people are driving, it's a problem. I don't want a big house. I just want a nice house. And that, don't let me see so that I can so. Why are they giving you all this big house? What are they going to do? It's because of selfishness. It's the same thing that dominated Judas Iscariot. When they really poured the oil on Jesus, he said, no, look at how expensive it is. They were saving and giving to the poor. They were always out of selfishness. So if we cannot deal with the subject of selfishness, we are not going to live a sin-free life.
That's right.
We're not going to live a sin-free life. We need to deal with selfishness. We need to acknowledge our own weakness. I have to go through and allow the word of God to deal with my selfishness.
Amen.
They look at the abundance of others and they become jealous. Oh, what is the source of, my notes say, oh, consider the case of one who has, anger. And it's not hesitant to let me know. Do you think they are looking for the interest of others? Of course not. Once again, their focus is well on themselves. They tell it what cruel words they use. Has somebody ever spoken to you and you look like they slap you? You feel like crying. And they don't care what they say to you, they don't care what they call you. As long as it makes them happy. How many of you ever use words that you don't like to be used on you? Hello? Can I have a witness? How many of you ever use words that you don't like others to use it on you? Makes you feel foul. But if somebody uses it on you, you pop. The Bible says, do unto others what you desire. Wow. So you can look at others. If I say this to somebody, how does it feel? Yes. No, but you can say it to other people. You can call other people names. You can say whatever you like. If anybody dare to say, you hold the person today, you will see me. We wait one day for transition. But you can use it on others without thinking of how painful it is to them. Because you are selfish. Anger and hostility. There is a lot of symptoms that you need to notice that some people are withdrawn because of selfishness. They don't talk to others. Because they are selfish, they don't talk to me. That's how I like myself more than you. You don't talk to other people. You're selfish. They are always, they are special. You are the only one. Hello. How many of you feel special? Oh, come on, man. How many of you feel special? How many of you feel that there is no other person special like you? So you don't care about others. You are the only one. God has blessed you. Look at it from you. He has not blessed me. That's only blessed me. Because it's all about me. And when we carry this in our life, we miss three others. Because it's all about us. Okay, let's move. Take a case of people who are eating up with lust. Lust, L-U-S-T. Okay, let me come down. Think of the case of womanizer and manamizer. Because I always talk about womanizer, I don't talk about manamizer. You know, they are in a relationship, they don't really care about other people. They don't care about how their partners feel. People who cheat on each other, they blow through the roof if anybody cheats on them. Men will cheat on their wives. But if there are men and children, if their wife brings somebody, who was that? Even if his man is a classmate, what is he looking for? What is a classmate? Because it's all about them, selfishness. They don't care about how the woman feels. They just care about how they feel. As long as it makes them fine. Hello. It is out of selfishness you keep boyfriends, people that you're not legally involved with, and girlfriends. Why do you do it when the Bible says, you know, keep your body sanctified and get ready for marriage? So why do you steal? Pastor, I hope you still have members that are saved. Why do you steal? It's out of your selfishness. You hide and you steal. And you come to God. Oh, Jesus. And you are in something that is despicable, and God sees it. Why do you do it? When the Bible says no. Why are you in it? For whose interest? For me. How many of you know that? How many of you still like me? Why do you do it? Just tell me why. It is not because of yourself. It is a simple procedure. If you want to begin to tango, legalize it. Does somebody legalize it? Bring it out, let us see. Put a stamp on. Give you license to drive 24 hours, 7 days a week. But you will not. You will rather. That is our pastor. Selfish interests hidden from us that we don't know. You can lift up your hand. How will you lift up your hand? Everybody's doing it. It's about the requirement of the Word of God. It's about how we can get more people in the church, get more money, and live big. So, you know, nobody preaches it, because if you preach this too much, you have less members like we have. Not that we cannot grow. How many of you know that people don't like our church? Not because we don't have, we even dance, say, feel free and dance. We dance enough time. Every time we have to, they still won't come, because when it comes to the word of God, you know, it's straight. There is a need. So you're not going to have people in the church here feel all the hallelujah. My congregation is 20,000. No, you might not get it here. You're going to be here because you love the word of God and you love the truth. And you know, you want to be in a relationship with God that is more functional, that will take you to see Him. Because life is not always about here. One of these days you're going to disappear from here. This is a transition camp. And when we stand before God to give account of our life, and everything that we thought that was secret is already been known before we get there. Oh, Jesus. Tell somebody, this church is good.
Church is good.
Are you saying it from your heart? I'm not saying it from your heart. Don't feel that. But you know, this is the truth. And when we go through this process, you know, now you could just imagine, you know, what a blessed thing it would be for you to wait on God and enter into a proper relationship. How sanctified and how happy you will ever be. So when we cheat, it's for us. How many of you ever steal something before? I'll let go my hand. I'm a so professional in taking hot meat and putting my mouth. I have air conditioning in my mouth. You will never notice that the meat is hot. If my mother walks into the kitchen, you don't see me smiling with this hot meat. But if you try this, you will not be able to eat for 2 days. But I have a technology out there to locate the meat that you know the hotness will come. I will still be talking. You don't know this meat. How can you have some paper for this? That selfishness has taught you only. Nobody has taught you. Those who teach you, no teacher talks to you that you just know it. Because yourself, you should develop some technology how to operate. Just don't watch my mother, you don't cook the meat. If it's boiling, I'm watching it. Boiling, I'm watching it. Once you move, because she was a teacher, and he's writing notes. Put it there. Mommy, what are you doing? There's part of it. As if I didn't know he was writing notes from lesson. Just to make sure that I'm clear that you know nothing happened. It's out of selfishness. And that's how come you operate. That's selfishness teach you to become it. And not to be straight. Selfishness teaches you how to lie and pretend that it was all true. Nothing happened. No, I never said anybody. How many of you ever lied and you look like this too? And people even knew, even lie and grace supporters, when people support you in your life, they don't know that you're lying. Because you perform it so professionally that you know even the people around you say, hey, Levi, we know her. We know him. He's telling the truth. And you grace up, and then inside you know your life. Can I have a witness in the house? How many people are good liars? Or where? And then steal people lies. When you lie, how many lies are for selfish interest? If you don't have anything to lie about, if you don't like somebody, you tell the truth about the person. How many of you know that? Any person you don't like, you tell the truth. If somebody said, I'm seeing this sister, they're coming to the church, I thought, you know, maybe she could be a good. That one is driving here. You will tell the truth. It's not the one. No, your guy's here. Sorry, it's driving you. You tell the truth immediately because you don't like the person. But if the person you like, right choice. Even though you know it's the wrong choice. Why? Self. Somebody said selfish. It's the foundation of all lies. You lie because you're selfish. That's why you lie. Mm-hmm. You don't lie because the devil beat you. No, the devil made me do. Let's leave the devil for a minute. Why did you go and sleep with her? It's the devil. It's the devil that made you pregnant. No demon makes you pregnant. That is the devil. It's not the devil, it's you. It takes a process for that to happen. The devil was not on top of you, it was the devil who were up. Selfishness. So now when taking care of someone, lying or taking up a loss is out of selfishness. And when we operate in this way, there are consequences. There are everything done out of selfishness, there is consequences in our lives. Because the Bible said, the labor must not be mocked. God is not deceived. Whatever a man sows, that is, when you cheat on the, how many of you have been caught cheating before? Like me. Now you always look at you looking at me. I know you won't confess anything, you are better than me. Good, praise the Lord for you. How many of you have been caught cheating before? Yeah. Wonderful people. Thank God for you. That's why you continue to cheat, because you've not been caught. that we read from verse 5. Say, have this attitude in yourself, which was also in Christ Jesus, who although he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality with God to a thing to be grasped. But he emptied himself, even though he existed with God. He did not, think equality with God. Some of you, if you were like Jesus, said, God, go by yourself, go there and suffer for these people. I don't know them. If you were like Jesus, you are equal with God. And they say, who will go? You'll be looking at Holy Ghost, you go now. Those people, I'm not going to go. But the Bible said Jesus emptied himself. He came down. He did not thought it be a robbery. He did not thought it anything. He humbled himself to go through all of that without, having on your friends, to sacrifice his life for you. If they live like a believer, prefer others. Sacrifice your life for others, for God. If you look at the contract with the devil said, I will Lucifer said, I will be like the Most High God. That is selfishness. You go now. In the God and the Father, the Son, of God, who will go for us? If I was Jesus, I said, are you not the Father of them? Go. You go. Go there to the end and walk there for those people and die for them. I'm not going. But he emptied himself. Somebody say he emptied himself. He preferred you when you did not even know him. He loved you enough to die for him. And he didn't know you. He didn't have to do it. And he demanded, he blessed the man on us as his followers to live like that. To be able to love other people so much in such a way that the love of God can flow through us. He said, taking the form of a bondservant and being made in the likeness of man, and being found in appearance as man. I'm reading from a new translation here. He humbled himself by becoming, obedient to the point of death, even the death on the cross. The Bible said, therefore, There is always a blessing when you exhibit selfless service. If you want more blessing. Now think of Abraham and Lot. God told Abraham. The Bible says that Lot followed, God did not call Lot. How many of you know that? He followed Abraham. It was just a relationship. And he got blessed. And the Bible says, it came to the time that, the headmates of Lot begin to fight the headmates of God. If you were Abraham, what would you do? Be sincere. I would chase Lot and his people away because God did not call him. God gave me this land, not you. And now you're fighting me. I brought you to be idiot. Now you're fighting for my people. I pack your things and go. Don't ever let me see you around this area. Amen. I will do that. That's what I brought to you. May God call me. He didn't call me. He gave me the role of this land. And then I like to take your love. I do you a favor. I want to be fair. Do you a favor. God called me. He gave me the land and to bless me. And out of my blessing, I give you some. Now you're growing big. You're growing rich. You're growing rich. I'm top of the world. Bring me to who? Father Abraham, bring me to me. Pack you and your father. Leave it. What did you come here with? Two clothes. Take it and go. The one I bought for you is over. Leave it. When you came here, you came with two shoes. Leave God with two shoes. The one I bought for you and I gave to you, I have changed my mind. I'm not giving to you again. Go. Does it sound like somebody? Does it sound like you? Take it and go. God, go. Go back. This God gave me this place. The God of heaven don't know about you. Did you know about your refugee like the people here? Who showed you the way? But just do it small thing, but now you need to grow this.
That's exactly what I would have done to God.
So my friend, what did not call me? This is my day. I walk around. This is my place. God gave me this place. I hear his voice, you hear his voice. You know how many days I passed before I hear it? You know the prayer I read before I get to it. You just come right here. I give this small space and I give you grow wings. Don't grow wings somewhere, not here.
But the Bible says something that Abraham, when he heard of the contention of the hearers of Lot, and then he came and said, Lord, you know what? I give you preference. Make a choice. Wherever you will go. In my territory, if I even give you whatever it is, if I give you like this,
I'm going to be like, you know, you ask my son to give you meat. The one he will give you, you can, even if you use my own. Well, because he has given you, just so at least you will be accepted for you. The one that will cut for you, you give.
That's what I would have given to you.
If I was, whatever Abraham said to God, take wherever, whichever side you will choose, there is. He gives you preference. That is it. And the Bible says, after that, God blessed Abraham. When you are able to operate him, you know, in some lessons, you get the direct blessings from God. It's not because you're a loser. But because you trust God to bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many of you would have been like Joseph? Sold into the pit. Came from the pit to Potiphar's house. From Potiphar's house to prison. After all I've been through. I'm now the prime minister. I see you come. You people that wanted to kill me. How many of you? If you give them food, it will be poison. How many of you like to revenge a little bit? Not too much. Take for time. Just do me, I do you. God is not annoyed. Small, small. Not too much. How many of you would have been like Joseph? That after all the pregnant look before him, and now he's in the position of authority and power. To pay them back. The moment he saw them, he said, look at them, they're coming. God has punished you. You are coming to look for God.
Kneel down there.
What are you going to come and buy? You are looking for God. Did you plant it here? Did they say it's a farm here? The way you would have talked, you know, when you know, go read the story. Joseph, after all he went through in their brother's head, when they saw them, take them to his. If you even allow them to sit outside your house, it will be a blessing. Sit there. If you bring him to the palace, it's the junior palace, not the main palace, where the children are playing, that you are very good. Sit to that side. Not in your main palace. It's your enemy. But Joseph brought them to his chamber and had them drink from the golden cups. Make a leap on with them. Love them. But you know, I don't think I would have been like Joseph. When I remember what I went through the pit, when I remember my suffering and how they lied to me in Potiphar's house, where I spent 14 years of imprisonment because of you guys, and now you are suddenly appeared. How many of you will be known? There are people who want to come to your church because of what they did to you 1932. You won't even give them the name of the church. How can they come to church in your church? So that let them continue to go to wherever they're going. Take them to my church. These are my enemies. How many of you have enemies in your spirit?
That if anything happened to them, yes, God is answering my prayers. Yeah, that they, you know, they replace and hit their car. They never hit it, they don't hit it.
You are happy about their downfall. You are happy about their pain. Why?
Because you're selfish.
Joseph bring them and set them in a place equal and treat them for loyalty.
I don't think I have that grace yet. And I know that some of you, how many of you would have done it? How many of you would have shown them better? Make them feel that you know that you're in charge. How many of you would have been like you made them feel in a good way, like sit outside there? Sit outside there. They would have waited for how many of you have people who have come to see you and you're not happy with them? You make them wait until they are sick. Even the and by here they need to go and they sit and sit and sit their attention. Is this still good? Let them wait. How many of you ever have people waiting for you out of judgment? Because you're offended. Let them wait there. And when you come and hey, you go past it, you can wait. If you come and they don't even know, they think that you are very good. They don't know they are punishing them. Are you still waiting? Wait, you know, today is a great busy day. You know, be patient, I'll be with you. You wait and get tired. I'm going to be like that.
But you know, that's how we manifest selfishness. I see it in my life also.
So I'm talking about myself. I'm talking about you. I know you're a very good person. I'm talking about you. They come to see you. You just look. On outside, you're smiling with them. But inside, they say, you know, you won't come. God has punished you. They told you, you won't come back. And the person does not know. The person has forgotten the things that he has done against you. Because it's like 5 days ago. But you never forget. Say, I will forgive you, but I won't forget. You are not forgiven. Why would you forget? And why would you keep the memory of the things that you've forgiven? Is it not out of selfishness? I will forgive you, but you know, I won't forget. And you can that makes you look good. I've forgiven you, but I'm not forget. And it makes you look spiritual. You know, you're very spiritual. I've forgiven you, but I'm not forgetting it. And you're very spiritual. Why don't you forget it? Why do you give them money? You give them money for yourself. I can forgive you, but I won't forget. How many of you are like that?
Yes.
Won't forget anything. Won't forget anything that you give to me. I'm forgiving you, I won't forget. Why do you keep it? Is it not because of you?
Yes.
You give me so that 9 o'clock last year, you did this and wasted it. That's why you keep it. Because you keep record. How many of you have record of wrongdoings? How many of you have that? And what is it that daddy is in daddy of offense? That's what you call it. People that have wronged you. Today you look at me from head to toe and I'm it. I don't know what it means, but the way you look at me, I don't like it. Selfishness. If God can deliver us, you and me from selfishness, life will be better. People around us will be blessed. We will become instruments of power. Do you understand how the brothers of Joseph felt when Joseph one time came and said, I am your brother? The Bible said they broke down and they cried on the road. So what you meant evil for me, God has turned him out for good. Because everything that happens to you that God, when God allows situation to come into your life, it is meant for your own good. It sometimes is not all right with you, but God that allows you knows what is the problem. Say, what you guys meant for evil for me, God has done it to be good. Because you are not forgiving them, you are not treating them because of yourself, you are treating them because of God. It's not because you see, the problem of the 21st century is the issue of rights. How many of you know your rights? Now, how many of you know your rights, like women? Women rights, child rights, husband rights, wife rights. It's all about selfishness. My right, this is my right. And the fight for it, it's my right. Who says it's not your right? Can you surrender your right for the right of others? Because that would be a selfless. Joseph would have said, it's my right to inflict you, to punish you a little bit. Not too much. Just let you taste what I taste. 50%, not 100%. Just go through 50% of what I come back. No, come back another day. How many of you have no punished people like that? Go and come back. You can do it now. But you feel that, like, you know, if you are giving to me now, it's just like you move on, you go and come back tomorrow. You can do it now, but you don't do it. Give me, let's give me, no, go and come back. Go and come back. And when you come back tomorrow, you say, yes, what is it that we were talking about? You pretend that you did not. Because if it makes you feel, go and come back. If a person took time, can I see you? I'm in this situation, I need 500 grand. So, okay. Meet me tomorrow. Come back by 4 o'clock, I'll get it ready for you. And the person come back by 4 o'clock and you serve hand. So what were you saying the other time? And you remember? And he was asking for 500 men.
Yeah.
And now and the person asked for still his testimony again. I was going to say, I need this. And he said, you know, I totally forgot. Hey, you know, come back by 6 o'clock this week. Who is even gonna come? I'm going out now. Come back by 6. The person has to go. Because of self. Joseph would have said, go back and come back. After 2 weeks, come back. I will see. I will look if there's any come to sell for me. Because of selfishness. The Spirit of the Lord said to me, I'm working on myself as I'm preaching to you. I'm helping myself. So that we can all be delivered from selfishness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to be delivered from it. Selfishness will deliver us from sin. I will be open and straight. I will be real person. Once I am selfless, I will be able to speak the truth. I have nothing to hide. If I have something to hide, it's for me. I'm selfish. How many of you can declare how much you make to your partner? They don't know what I make. I don't want anybody to know my income. Because they'll start asking me of money every time they see me.
Okay.
How many of you are afraid of people asking for money? So you laugh. You see this job, I'm just doing it because I don't want to see that. What they pay, it doesn't even buy me anything. Why are you going? How many people say something like that? If they know that I get 10,000, all of them, all my family, they will be eating here. So when I go, you see, even if they tell me, I want to resign, people say, no, don't resign. I want me to resign. This job is not paying. Meanwhile, they pay you well. You don't want people to know how much you earn. Because you don't want them to come asking for favors. Oh Jesus, that's why I'm going to the church. God help us in church. Help us in this church. Amen!
Amen.
Never tell them how much is in your pocket. You do like this. You know how to touch your pocket and bring out empty, but something is inside. How many of you have to touch? Nothing. Because you see this.
500, not even 100 is a walking stone. Not nothing. These times, everything is blocked. There's 500 here, but the person just needs to figure out. Nothing. Life. Only Jesus can save you. And Jesus put you in a position to help. Only Jesus can help us. We will be praying for you. How do you pray for somebody that is hungry? What is it? Tell me the manner. Which manner will you use to pray? Go. You know, in the name of Jesus Christ, be healed. What are you praying for? Nothing. You have a place in your purse. You can enter your purse. 1,000 can be there, you will not drop. You created another compartment when you buy that purse. To put a place to put money. How many can you have? Like even if people they took it, you will take them going to laboratory to scan your purse to know that there is money. They will never discover that money in the purse, even if they pocket it. And you can empty the purse. See, nothing here. Nothing. And you have it. How many of you have handbags like that? You can pour out lipstick, ice stick, blue stick, any stick can fall, but no money. Will never fall. Money will never fall here. Even green stick can fall. Money to fall, never. You know where it is. Selfishness. I know it because I practice it. Not because the Bible teaches me, I know it. It's a part of the human nature to hide things, keep things for self, because you don't want to share selfishness. God said to me, in this season, many of you are bound to be blessed once you give yourself, because when your blessing is not going to be limited, that's why my blessing is not limited. Your blessing is not going to be limited because you are about to become a channel of blessing. A source where blessing flows through. It's another thing to be blessed, it's another thing to be a blessing. When you are a blessing, it does not end. When you are blessed, it starts and stops. But when you are blessing, you are a channel where it flows through, you will never lack. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And the only hindrance is not anything, you know. I have prayed for each of you. I know, I pray, I take my time to sit in the altar and pray for every person that I know by face in this assembly. And I know that no devil is possessing you.
Amen.
No witchcraft is attacking you.
Amen.
There's no demon.
Yes.
Come on. You know that we are past come out level. There's nothing inside you to come out. If there's anything that is coming out, you should be selfishness. You should come out. Not the devil.
Yeah.
I'm not like, have you seen me do warfare in the name of Jesus? Bind you, cast him out, break the leg. All of that is over because you don't have no demon inside you. But what you need to do is character change for the blessing to begin to flow. You are not possessed. There is no family which is that is stopping you. That's why I don't have deliverance service. Pastor, let us have night. If you have all night prayer, you'll be surprised. You'll be thanking God from 11 to 12. You'll be bored. You'll be bored because there's no deliverance. How am I going to deliver from you? Tell me who's possessed here. Point to one member of this church that is still having the demon there. There's nobody here that is possessed. So why aren't you doing deliverance prayer? Pastor is not doing deliverance prayer again. What am I going to deliver you from? There's no demon inside you. We finish all the demons long time. That's why you don't lay hands in into. You don't fall down and stand up there. Who's going to be? There's no demon inside you. Hello?
Amen.
We need to do that prayer. My prayer for what? If you come for that prayer, it's thank you, Jesus. Jesus, I love you. Hallelujah. Thank you. And you're going to be bored. Because there's nobody to deliver here. Point to look at your neighbor and say, look at somebody, Trump is a disgrace. demon, I want to deliver you. Master,
no, they are not possessed.
There is no witchcraft based on that is work upon your life. You have been born again, you have been sanctified, you have been saved. The only thing that is remaining is a character change for the blessings of God to begin to manifest in your life. So forget about prayer or fighting and losing, casting out, finding, I pray the devil, you know, all the generation, there's no generational curse upon you again. Hello? You have been delivered. It's not generational. If there is any generational curse, it's 60 selfishness that is your own name. And it doesn't need prayer, it needs you to act. We look for enemies to bind. Prayer against my enemy. 7 days fasting against my enemy. Who's your enemy? It's yourself. Open up. Begin to obey the Lord God. Allow God to walk in your life. All I need is you, Lord Jesus. I need a quiet to come on this evening. I need a quiet. Allow God. I need somebody in the house today who said, I will allow God to walk in my life. I will allow God to walk through me and be a source of blessing. That's all we need. There are many things. Do you understand how much people's blessing are tied to your life? Do you understand how much people will be blessed in your neighborhood, will be blessed in your job places, will be blessed in your family? Only you allow God to walk through you. If only you allow God. If only you yield yourself to God. As the Spirit of the Living God, I surrender to you, Lord Jesus. I don't have no limitation at all on that self anymore. Jesus, it's all for you, Lord Jesus. It's all for you, Lord Jesus. Our church is entering into a new season. The only time somebody died in the New Testament church was selfishness that came. We are coming to the place whereby everything that I have belongs to Jesus and you can access it. That's what I told the pastor. You open up businesses that he makes, you open it up to us. Hello. He brought us into the business. If you didn't enter, it's because you too, you are suspicious of everything. Selfishness. Now they say they want to do business. We went there for church, now they say they want to do business. But these people, they are looking for money. They go to business meeting. I'm not attending business meetings. I'm going to church. What kind of business? They have come with an idea to collect money from us. The selfishness are taking my money. Otherwise, you were not there. You were there. And you did not enter. When the door opened, when the man of God stood up and said, no, I am working in the Department of Education. I made my money from there. So I kept to worship you. And you never take the opportunity. When they say those who are interested in business, have business idea, want to get into business, we're behind. Is that why I come to church? Let me go now. Selfishness. Some makes you suspect other people. You are suspicious of everything. Thank you. possible, and I want you to write it out. Every blessing that you will ever get in life on earth is based on relationship. Let me say that again. Every blessing that you will get in life on earth is based on relationship. Somebody say relationship. Every blessing you get in life is based on relationship. If God were dropping packets from the sky, there would have been a campaign. People would have died of the fish before the packages. So God passed the packages to people. If there's a place, if they say, come to enemy stadium, God is going to upload there. Will you be able to travel there? Will you be able to contest? There are people with muscles who stand like this. There are people taller than you that will catch the package before the enemy stadium. And you're my size. You won't be able to catch. How many people are there? They just look up their hand when the person comes to the But God said, no, I'm going to bless you through relationship. Every person that you are related to, either in one place, you need to understand this, in family, is a source of blessing. Unless you see it, you cannot access it. It's a source of blessing. Never see any relationship as a liability. Has a blessing attached to it. The why you cannot access it is your selfishness. Because by before the talk, why do you say you love me? Because I'm working at it. If I was not happy working in the back, would you love me? Because you're thinking of yourself. We have entered into the season of abundance. That's why the Holy Spirit tells me.